I want to tell you about the best place to buy your seeding trays. I got this one at Walmart, $4.87. Anywhere else I've seen them are like $8 to $12. So you get your shell, then you get the top, and you get soil in there or plants. You put that over until the seeds come up, and once they come up, you take the dome off. So this one right here, Dollar Tree. I love these for when I just have a few seeds or something to plant. Doesn't come with a nifty tray inside, but great, best place to have it. What I like to use for potting soil is the Miracle-Gro because it has the fertilizer in it already. When I was younger and wanted to go through the trouble, I used to make my own potting soil, which was one-third potting soil, one-third perlite, one-third vermiculite, and then I put some like Osmocote or some other fertilizer in with it. But now I just spend the money and buy the Miracle-Gro because I'm old and I don't want to fool with it. Time for buying seeds. Actually, I like to buy most of mine in January because gardening has become so popular. But seeds are like buying milk. It all comes from a cow. It doesn't matter what brand you buy. The same with seeds. So Walmart, or this is Dollar Tree. Dollar Tree has seeds for $4. Doesn't matter. You may not get as many seeds, but a lot of you aren't going to have great big gardens. So actually, sometimes I'll even just buy several of these. Still cheaper. Walmart has them for 50 cents. This is my most expensive seed, my favorite tomato seed, and I actually pay $6.99 for 25 seeds. So, and the only reason I do that is because Burpee is the only one that makes my favorite tomato seed, which is Super Sauce Hybrid. Go get your seeds. Actually, my favorite seed company is actually one out of Maine called Pine Tree, and you won't get as many seeds in their packets, but they're much, much cheaper than other seed companies that I know of. And if you're not going to have to plant a farm, this is a way to go. I love Pine Tree. Their URL is superseeds.com. I want to talk about open pollinated or heirloom seeds versus hybrid seeds. If you're a seed saver, you want to get heirloom varieties that you can save the seeds at the end of the year, dry them out in a paper towel and save them, keep them in a cool place. Or why would anybody want a hybrid seed if you can't save the seed? And the reason is because the hybrid seeds are made from two different or more varieties where they cross-pollinate. Most of them tend to be less disease resistant than the open pollinated or heirloom seeds, but it's like this tomato seed right here will give me the biggest paste tomatoes I've ever seen, so I plant a lot of these. You have to be a little more careful with planting non-disease resistant or less disease resistant places seeds if you live in a humid area, because you'll get more diseases there. Where I live, it's nice and dry, so I don't really get too many fungal diseases. So I will go with the hybrids or the varieties that I like. Today we're going to be planting broccoli, and this is my favorite type of broccoli. It's Pac-Man. And the reason I like Pac-Man, although it's getting harder to find, the heads are okay. They're just your normal broccoli head. The thing I like about this one is that the side shoots are amazing. I mean, this broccoli keeps going all from spring to fall. And I've even had side shoots as big as the heads. They're amazing. So I'm going to plant these, the quarter inch deep for the broccoli. Put my little seeds in here. I'll land it over there. Got two over here. Let's see. These are so tiny it's hard to see. It looks like I'm probably going to plant 18 broccoli plants. Hard to get, they're so tiny, it's hard to get just one in each cell. You're gonna see how small these things are. I know they're smaller seeds, but for an old lady like me, it's hard to keep track of little ones like this. Now, quarter inch, I'm just gonna press them down. A lot of times, I'll just put another quarter inch of soil on it. These cells are pretty full, so I'll just kinda mix them in there. Ooh, that one was deeper. Okay. I've pretty good luck with broccoli over the years. And I've tried many varieties, and I can't find any I like better than the Pac-Man broccoli. Let's move on to cauliflower. The family of plants that I'm planting right here, the cabbage, the broccoli, the cauliflower, even Brussels sprouts, which I won't grow, because they're just aphid magnets and I can't control them. These are called brassicas. And brassicas are good cold weather plants. You can go three seasons. Cauliflower is actually probably best planted as a fall crop here up in the northern half of the United States. But I like to put in a spring crop, wish for best luck, and then I'll plant another fall crop, which I will plant the seeds in July, outside. My favorite variety of cauliflower is actually called Cloud. And this is always an early snowball, and a snowball, why they're planted just the way the broccoli is. And the seeds look the same. And the reason I'm planting so much more cauliflower than broccoli is because, like I said, the Pac-Man broccoli just keeps going and going, whereas once you cut off a head of cauliflower, it's pretty much done. Some of them will produce side shoots, but that's my experience has been that's been pretty rare. So I planted a lot of cauliflower, and then once I cut the cauliflower, I pulled the plant out. One thing about brassicas is it's very important not to plant them the same place 2 years in a row. And really, that's a good practice for all of your garden because certain diseases build up. With brassicas, the worst disease you can get is club root. Club root is when the stem of the broccoli and the root actually look like a club. They get really, really thick. And if you get club root in your soil, you can't plant anything there for 9 years. So it's very important that you don't plant the same plants in the same place year after year. Rotate. Okay, I'm going to take out this popsicle stick. I love these fat popsicle sticks to mark with out here in the house. And I am going to put early snowball there. Now, just for comparison, I'm going to do my snowball Y in these last two rows here. Which means I should probably put a snowball Y marker there. And then we'll just put our, how far I am there. Try to get one seed in each cell, but sometimes that's more difficult than you might think. Teeny, tiny seeds. I'll tell you a little bit of something about seeds. Some people are into organics. I'm not. I just bought this organic seed because that was what I could find. Time for some spring cabbage, and this is from my favorite seed company. It's a little company in Maine called Pine Tree Seeds, and email, the website address is superseeds.com if you're interested. The reason I like them is because they sell seeds, a small amount of seeds, for a cheaper price. So I get a lot of things. This is my favorite cabbage. Now, come fall, I'll plant a whole bunch of cabbages so I can make sauerkraut. But this is a 0.1. It is a pointed cabbage, and it grows really quickly. Let's see, it's see how many days is 48 days to harvest for, or from transplant. When you grow seeds in here, in the house like this, all the dates or how long it will take are going to be from transplant, not from when you start the seed. So 0.1 cabbage seeds are going to look just the same as the broccoli and the cauliflower, little itty bitty ones, and I am just going to do this last row with 0.1 cabbages. I'm only going to grow a half dozen this spring. I'll probably grow a dozen or 18 come fall, and I will grow different varieties. I always like the short season ones, so I can just go out and get a cabbage whenever I want to, but they're also the big ones for kraut, and you might want to start those out in the garden maybe the 1st of May. So you have these, like, there's one called Megaton or Danish ball head. Those are really big ones. There's also a cabbage I like called Krautman. And although it's not huge, it's big enough. I like a cabbage called Stonehead. But we'll get to that in July. For February, we're just going to plant these, and I'm just going to kind of play chopsticks and push in these seeds all across. So, how do we water these wonderful Walmart 487 trays? I just lift it up and put the water in there. Now, I'm not going to really water this now. This is going to hold half a gallon of water. And the reason is because it's going up on top of my kitchen cabinet, and I don't want to lift all that water up and have the plant, the seed tray just splatter me with water. So once I get it up there, then I'll water. That's how you do it. And really, you can just check it once a week with this. And of course, we're going to put on our dome to make sure the water stays in there. Got my Dollar Tree little greenhouse. When I'm just planting a few seeds or something, these are great. Now you're going to think I'm crazy just planting tomatoes in February. But these are Siberia tomatoes, my very favorite early tomatoes. Last year I got my first tomato on June 19th, which is pretty darn good. They're comparable to any other early tomato, except they're bigger. They're probably 2 to 3 inches in diameter. And they are very cold tolerant. They go down to like 45 degrees without a problem as far as setting fruit and doing that. Most tomatoes set fruit at between 55 and 85 degrees. These are very cold hardy. So these will be going in the garden probably the 1st of April. I may need to cloche them or cover them up in some way if the nights are getting too cold. But very good tomato. I love my Siberias. And I'm going to plant them. I'm only going to plant half a dozen of them because I just want my early tomatoes. They're definitely not my main crop. So I'll put half a dozen in here, and as it gets, they get bigger, I will transplant them individually into pots. I've got my Miracle-Gro soil in here. I love Miracle-Gro soil. It's so much easier than making my own, but if you're one of those that wants to make your own, like I used to when I was younger and had more energy, a third parts of potting soil, a third part vermiculite, and a third part of perlite will give you a good potting soil. And then just throw in some like Osmocote or some kind of fertilizer in there. But the Miracle-Gro people have done that for me, so I'm quite happy with that. Now, these Siberia produce 48 days after transplant. Like I said, super early. Now I need to cover them with a quarter inch of soil, so I'm just going to kind of guesstimate a quarter inch here. Press it down real well. Put in our little sign. I snap these in half because the cover won't go on otherwise. There's our Siberia tomatoes. I've talked before about rotating the soil, your planting areas, and how important it is so that diseases don't build up in the soil. The thing is, it's not just a single plant, but a family of plants that you cannot plant after you've planted the same family plant. So these, I'm doing peppers and tomatoes and eggplants. I'm not planting eggplant this year, but they are all from the family Solanae, and you cannot plant in the same place where Solanae plant had been last year. Potatoes also, family of Solanae. So we're going to get started with our peppers. We're going to start off with California Wonder, a nice green pepper, very standard. All right, our California Wonder peppers also receive a quarter inch or so of soil. Press it down, and we will get our marker and our lid. These, unfortunately, you're just going to have to water straight on, no underneath part. Next up, I'm just going to plant some mixed peppers. This is a Grand Bell mix. I want to tell you something about seeds and seed quality. Doesn't matter. It's like getting a gallon of milk from the grocery store. Do you care what brand it is? It all came from a cow. The same thing goes with seeds, is this all came from peppers. So if you can find, this is a $4 seed at Dollar Tree. I know Walmart has seeds for 50 cents, and I believe Walgreens has too, at least they used to. I haven't been there for a while. But if you can get the cheap seeds, get them. There's no difference between this and an expensive burpee or something like that. Okay, now this seed packet contained that much seed. Not a lot, but I am not going to plant a lot of peppers this year because I freeze-dried so many in the past. So I'm just going to plant 6 of these seeds and be good with my Grand Bell pepper mix of all different colors. I will probably end up transplanting these into individual pots as they grow as well. And we're going to put our quarter inch of soil. These are 65 to 85 days. California Wonder ones are 85 days. You remember, what's on the seed is days from transplant, not from seeding. Mixed bells. And we're done with that one, except for the watering. And we can water, you can water with a spray bottle if you want, or if you're very gentle, you can water it overhead. You just don't want to move the seeds around, so that's why you need to be pretty careful. Okay, I know a lot of you love hot peppers. We don't. we are really chicken when it comes to heat. So I'm going to grow like 2 jalapeno plants, maybe for nachos or jalapeno jelly or chipotle peppers. I'm going to grow just a couple of those. And then I'm going to cram actually 8 pepper plants into this one because I'm going to transplant them into bigger things anyway. Okay, so there's my Anaheims right there. Those are my jalapenos. See, I'm already mixing these up. These are my jalapeno peppers. And then our hot is chili peppers, which I love the Anaheims. They give flavor with just a tiny, tiny bit of heat, so that's what I like. We use a lot of chili peppers. We've canned them, we freeze-dried them. We've made chili relleno's. We go through quite a few of these, but like I said, in past years I've freeze-dried so many of them that I'm not going to worry about growing a ton of peppers this year. And let's see, I think we'll do the poke method with these. Put in my Anaheim sign and the cover. I'm going to be planting celery. There's lots of varieties out there, but I'm going with the good old standard Utah 5270. It works well for me. So I have soaked my itty bitty little seeds in water for 24 hours, which it helps to aid the germination of them. Celery should be planted this early and planted in inside and then planted outside maybe in April. It's a very slow growing, long season plant. So a lot of people will tell you to mix sand in with this and spread it, but I'm just going to kind of flick it in there, here and there. Maybe I should just pour a little bit. And I'll have it watered too, huh? Stir it up a little. And I'm going to cover it with just an eighth of an inch. Hope that's an eighth of an inch and not too much soil. And I'll put my tag in it and put the seed tray on, and we're good for celery.
So the broccoli and the cauliflower and the other seeds we just planted are on top of our cabinets, where we have lights hanging from the ceiling. This is a good place, and it's out of the way. It's nice and warm up here, and it's a good place to keep them. The red coating you see right here is a product called Red Guard, which helps keeps everything nice and dry and the water doesn't leak down into the cabinets. So when these are sprouted, we're going to go ahead and take the lids off and then water them by hand.